Before we look at what we need to see in this video, I wanted you to see an example of why you need to know about in behavior. If you'll notice in the problem that I've got, it is a parabola, exponent, largest exponent's 2, my coefficient's positive, so that means both ends, left hand and right hand, should be up. Now, watch the graph. Now, this is on Zoom 6, the one that we play with a lot. And if you'll notice, this looks like a straight line. If you didn't know any better, you would say that this is a straight line as opposed to a parabola. So knowing what the curve should look like is to your benefit, because what window you have your graph on, you know, that's going to determine what you see. We could go get our vertex, and then we could modify our window to see what the parabola looks like. But just taking it for face value, no, it's not a straight line. So I wanted you to see that. So let me clear that parabola out. And now we'll look at rational functions and models. It's a different type of function that we haven't seen before. They're actually a rational function is a quotient of two polynomials. I've got a polynomial p of x in the numerator and q of x in the denominator. No common factor other than negative 1 and 1, and q of x is not the zero polynomial. I cannot have division by zero. Now notice here, because we have to talk about domain. The domain of this function consists of all inputs x for which q of x does not equal zero. My denominator cannot be zero, and it's one of the things we have to look at when we are determining what's called an asymptote. An asymptote is an imaginary line that my curve snuggles up to. It might be a vertical asymptote, it might be a horizontal. Now this is your first encounter with asymptotes in this class, so we're going to look at some examples. And in the next video after this, I actually have some graphs that we actually do, that we go and find all the information that we can in order to graph it. So the first type of asymptote we need to look at is what's called a vertical. Now remember, a vertical is, you know, up and down. That's a vertical. So I might have more than one. But now here's the bottom line. To find any vertical asymptotes, set the denominator equal to zero and then solve for x. If whatever I find is a zero of the denominator but not the numerator, then the line x equals a is a vertical asymptote. The graph of a rational function will never ever cross a vertical asymptote. The domain cannot equal vertical asymptotes. So in this example, I'm looking for vertical asymptote. I'm going to set my denominator equal to zero. Let's see what I did. If I set it equal to zero, I add 2, divide by 3. My vertical asymptote is x equals 2/3. My domain, all real numbers except 2/3. Now, I don't have to put x equals 2/3 because, remember, domain is referring to your x's. So if you feel like it, you can, but your instructor will want the equation. So when you set the denominator equal to 0, keep that x. And if you remember, when we graphed linear equations, this did graph as a vertical line. Now, horizontal asymptotes, in a way, are a little bit quicker, but you have to compare. So when we determine horizontal asymptotes, we're going to consider two possibilities. There are three, but we're going to be required to know these two that I'm going to be looking at. If the numerator has a lower degree, so I need to look at numerator and denominator and see what my largest exponent is. So if the numerator has a lower degree than the denominator, there is a horizontal asymptote, and it's y equals 0. It's an automatic y equals 0. So in these two examples, I have y equals 5 over 2x minus 3. The degree in the numerator is 0. The degree in the denominator is 1. So my horizontal asymptote is just automatically y equals 0. And again, you need the variable here. Don't say horizontal asymptotes 0. You need y equals 0. Now in example 3, my degree in the numerator is 1, degree in the denominator is 2. When the degree is lower in the numerator than denominator, automatic, y equals 0. Now let me bring my calculator back up. And let's look at this one first. I'm already on y equals. If all you have is just a single number or a single letter in the numerator, you do not need a parentheses. Denominator, since it's a binomial, I do. I want you to see what the calculator looks like. Now on this one, talking about horizontal asymptote, my horizontal asymptote up here would also be y equals 0. So let me graph this. So right here at x equals 2/3, do you see how the curve is snuggling, going vertically, both down and up? It's snuggling. Now when we graph these, we put these asymptotes, they're imaginary lines, but we put a dashed line to indicate where they are. Now y equals 0 is the x-axis. Do you see how the curve is snuggling? So this is too important, very quick, but very important bits of the information that I need to find for this curve. So let's see. Let's look at example 2. See, that is 5. Let me go over here. I'll change this to 2, and I'll change this one to 3. Now if I set my denominator equal to 0, it would be, what, x equals 3/2. So let's see what my graph looks like. Notice it moved over from the other one, and it looks like it's at 1.5. Those of you with a TI-83, you actually see the vertical asymptote. Technically, your graph is in connect dot mode, so if you watch it, it comes in, zooms up, and then it goes off again. But I always tell my people with the 83s, they can see the vertical asymptote. 84 people, you have to sort of imagine this is where it's at. Notice how my curve is snuggling up again to the x-axis, which that's my horizontal asymptote, y equals 0. So let me get this down, and we've got another example. In the B part, if the numerator and denominator have the same degree, there is a horizontal asymptote, and the function is of this form. Okay, now remember we had this back when we were looking at just a generic form of a polynomial, but what I need you to see here is that my exponents are the same. It's important because this a sub n, b sub n, we have to focus on it. B sub n cannot equal 0, so y equals a sub n over b sub n, these two coefficients, that's my horizontal asymptote. Now it says the graph of a rational function may or may not cross a horizontal asymptote. If it does, it'll do it early. But what happens with a horizontal asymptote is we're looking at what happens to the curve as x goes to negative infinity and positive infinity, how it levels off. Now in braces here and in italics, I sort of summarize this. If numerator and denominator are of the same degree, the quotient of their coefficients, referring to the largest, you know, powers that you've got, is the horizontal asymptote. So this one, I have got degree of 1, degree of 1. My horizontal asymptote is y equals 3/2. I grabbed those coefficients. So let's see if that's what I did. Yep. Now if I was doing the vertical asymptote, set denominator equal to 0, I would have x equals negative 1/2. Let me get my calculator back up. I'll move it over here. So y equals. Now in this one, I need parentheses around both. I didn't graph this one, I don't think. No, I didn't. But on this one, you would need parentheses around negative 7x. Now earlier I said, as long as your numerator or denominator is a single number or single letter, you don't have to use parentheses. The best thing is just go ahead and put parentheses around numerator and denominator. That's the safest play, and you don't have to remember when you need it and when you don't. So 3x minus 2, parentheses 2x plus 1. Mask it to graph. See how it's leveling off? And it's leveling off at y equals 3 halves. Let me go back just a second. Let me put in 3 halves. See? It's leveling off. Now it looks like it comes up here and it hits it. It doesn't. It gets closer and closer and closer, but it just doesn't get there. So that's my horizontal asymptote. My vertical asymptote, if you remember, was a negative 1 half. Can you see it there? 83s, you can. 84s, it's there. Okay, so let me put that down. Now this one, don't always assume they're going to put it in descending order. As you scan through, I see the largest exponent up here is a 3. Denominator is a 3. So I have to put y equals negative 4 over 2, or y equals negative 2. So in these two horizontal asymptotes, A is the numerator's lower degree than denominator. B, numerator and denominator have the same degree. The third situation that we don't, you're not going to be responsible for, is if the degree in the numerator is larger than the denominator. Because it's not a horizontal asymptote anymore. It's called an oblique, and an oblique is slanted. So there might be some problems that you have to graph in the homework. And if you see one that has a larger degree in the numerator, graph it and see if it doesn't level off horizontally. It starts, it goes in a diagonal fashion, a slanted one. Okay, that's all for this one. Bye-bye.